Sorry guys, this is going to be a quick one for this Sunday. I have the RX6800XT. This is the next of the Navi 21 series that we were testing here on the OvalClocking, I guess, segment of the Ovalbore Tech Channel. Last week we did the 6800XL, and I know a lot of you guys were asking, Eric, what the hell is an XL? The XL is the non-XT. Everyone's like, well, I don't see that anywhere. It's not written on their website. I'm like, it's in the driver signature. You load it into MMPoS, it says RX6800XL, so please stop asking me about it. This week, XT, no confusion there. This is the slightly bigger brother initially released by AMD to combat the 3080 10GB, but really we find that this thing is really just like a really efficient 3070 or 3070 Ti in terms of mining. So right into it, I already highlighted the sheet, but you can see this thing is really good. The only algos I didn't fully highlight are Kylocoin, because again, I don't know what hash rates are considered good or bad, and then Ironfish, because I don't mine that regularly, and it's soon to be replaced with a new algo, Fish Hash anyway, which yes, I will be testing. But let's start at the bottom again, ProgPout. Even better somehow than the 6800XL. So we're getting 34.49 as our max hash rate, and that was with a 0.248 efficiency, which is still quite good. But I think I would still probably pick the 31.31 mega hash at 0.263 efficiency, which is even better than the 0.258 we saw with the XL. That thing is just a kapow monster, and it's only drawing 119 watts at the wall, well, at the PMD. Impressive. Very, very impressive. ETH hash, we fell in love with these things because they were so good at it. No change here. 0.541 hardware efficiency, 0.658 if you're a YouTuber running on software wattage. Ergo, really pretty good. 121 mega hash, 1.07 efficiency with that clock. And we actually got slightly better with like 3 mega hash lower, 1.16. So efficiency is really quite good there. Carlson, great. We're getting 2 to 3 times the average, like, cheapo entry-level GPU hash rate, and the efficiency is 13.35. I deemed arbitrary methods here at 0.8 being quite good, so these are really standout. Radiant, I was a little disappointed with the hash rate, but the efficiency is stellar. We're doing 13.35. That's Carlson again. We're doing 12.300. 10's my threshold there. Ironfish efficiency, I still gave it a pale green, even though it's only running 147, and 150 is my threshold on that one. So do with that info as you will. Alephium, we were getting crazy good efficiency, and this is relevant right now because Alephium is pumping. So 19.248 mega hash per watt, and then at slightly different clocks, our max hash rate was 1589, so 1.589 gigahash. Dynex, pretty solid hash rate. It wasn't worth, in my opinion, running the memory a little bit harder, but I did do it for you guys just because I had that request. 673 is still the mem clock that's most efficient on these, and yeah, 3.6 kilohash to get us an almost 50 hash to watt efficiency, which is good. It's not standout, and if you have a bunch of NVIDIA cards, just mine Dynex on those and throw these on something else. So they're good at it, but they're not, you know, waste this GPU's potential on it good. Nexa, hash rate's solid, but not great. So for an 80 tier card, it's pretty low. But for the class of like memory bus and compute and the current price of these things, I'm giving it a good score there. 0.540 efficiency is really good. That's only exceeded, I believe, by 40 series NVIDIA at this point, which are just Nexa kings. Flux, 51.32 souls. I'm going to give that a solid hash rate rating, even though you could push this harder if you really skyrocketed the clocks. It just doesn't stay efficient. We did actually get, I don't know why I highlighted that, we got over 0.6 soul per watt efficiency on this card, which is ludicrously good. I think we have touched that with a 40 series card, but these are significantly cheaper than anything Ada Lovelace right now. So again, somehow this is just as good, if not a little bit better, than the 6800XL. So if these are the same price in your region, scoop the XT, obviously. But if you're paying more than, I don't know, $20 to $40 more for this uplift, I personally probably wouldn't do it. I would stick with the regular XL. The cooler is a little bit better on this thing, so your mileage may vary there, but same memory subsystem, same memory, actually, same die. It's just a great card. So that's the 6800 XT. Stay tuned soon. I don't know if it'll be next week, but soon for the 6900 XT and maybe even the 6950 if I really get ambitious and want to test two cards at once. But anyway, thank you for watching. I will see you next week.